Okay, so click on new. GL account type is balance sheet account. Account group is going to be balance sheet, and here you will be providing the whatever bank details. Let's say this is my bank account. Okay, let's go to the control data now. Now in control data, account currency, balance in local currency, there are a lot of things which are as it is. There is no change. Open item management, even this was available in SAP ECC also, but there was one more field, line item display. Okay, do you remember line item display? There is no line item display here. Okay, in SAP S/4HANA, for any GL account, you cannot click on line item display. What is the reason? Okay, before I tell you what is the reason, can you tell me what was the purpose of that field? For which GL accounts we were ticking that indicator and for which GL accounts we were not ticking it? Question is, line item display indicator was available in ECC here. What was the purpose of that? Anyone, please try to answer. Just make it interactive, because otherwise, if I keep on speaking, you may not be able to grasp the things. Prashant, you are very silent. Please answer this. Just try to answer. Prashant.
Yeah, could you repeat the question once more, please?
Prashant, my question is, there was in ECC when we were
Yeah.
creating the Google account, there was open item management and there was one more field called as line item display.
Yeah, line item display, yeah.
Yeah, what was the purpose of that field?
Line item display. As of now, can't reproduce it, but actually I'm aware of open item management.
Okay, no problem. So I was just looking whether you are active on the call or not. No
No,
problem. Okay. So Mahesh, Sandeep, Akash, Varun, anyone, please try to answer this. I don't think this is very difficult question, right? All of you are working from many years in SAP ECC. So what is line item display?
I think system will show line-wise display. I
Sorry,
think
Akash.
system will show line-wise display.
Where it will show?
Sorry?
Where you will be able to see line item display? In which report?
In report, FBL like FBL 1 and 3N and 5N.
Yes. Okay. So normally this is relevant for FBL 3N. Because FBL 1N and 5N is not for GL, it is for vendor and customer. So for vendor and customer, line item display is always on. But this tick is for FBL 3N, to control FBL 3N. So if you don't tick that indicator, line item display, and if you go to transaction FBL 3N, and if you want to see all the line items posted in this GL account, you will get an error, line item display is not active for this GL. Right? Now, why SAP has provided this option? Why not for all the GL accounts line item display was on? Any idea? Why is it SAP was saying you have to tick this indicator if you want to go for line item display, otherwise it is not recommended for all GL accounts. Why it was not recommended for all GL accounts? Just a guess, why it was not recommended for all GL accounts? Just try to go back to our first session.
Because of the ledgers.
Sorry?
Because of the ledgers.
No, not exactly ledgers. In the first session, what we discussed, it was performance, speed, right? And what we discussed is more data, less speed. Okay, so if you have many
Storage
lines,
requirement, right?
yes, storage. So if you have many lines available in your tables, let's say if you want to see FBL3N in the lines, then obviously you have to tick that indicator. But that means that much number of line items will be stored in the table, which will consume your memory and your reports will become slow. And that is the reason SAP recommended that line item display should be only activated if you have a need to see the line item display report. It was not recommended for accounts like AR, AP. Why? Because AR and AP, anyways, you will be able to see the vendor-wise and customer-wise line items. So unnecessarily in FBL3N, you don't need to set up that for the reconciliation accounts. So the whole purpose was just try to reduce the number of line items which are getting stored in the table and to improve the performance. But now, when we are talking about SAP HANA database, we already discussed those all kind of restrictions are gone. Because HANA database is very fast, even if you have million billions of lines, it will not make any difference. Because we are using column-based data storage, we are using calculation engine, if you remember all those points that we discussed. And that is the reason SAP said, no worries, line item display will be active for all GLs going forward. So you don't need to specify whether the line item display is active or not, it will be by default active for all the GL accounts. Okay.
Okay.
Now, yeah, any question on line item display? Have you understood why it was available in ECC and why it is not available in S4HANA?
So, Gaurav, in ECC, like which type of accounts we don't keep this indicator on? Any idea?
Normally the reconciliation accounts. Customer vendor reconciliation accounts. Why? Because, see, customer vendor reconciliation means what? The reconciliation account that is assigned to the customer master. So let's say there is one GL account, 1000, okay, which is assigned to 10 customers. And whenever you post anything to this customer, the customer line items are already there in FBL file. So unnecessarily, again, if you activate it for the GL, there will be line items for customers creating separately and the line items which are getting created for GL separately. So in order to avoid that space, SAP was recommending that don't activate line item display for reconciliation accounts.
Okay, yeah.
Okay, and it was must for clearing accounts, all the different types of clearing accounts, GRIR clearing account, check clearing account, bank clearing accounts. So for all the clearing accounts, it was must. Line item display as well as open item management, we were taking it for all the type of clearing accounts. Okay, so open item management is available as it is. There is no change. But there is a new field called as clearing specific to ledger groups. What do you mean by this now? Clearing specific to ledger groups. Okay, let me explain. I'm not expecting the answer on this. So this is the same functionality as open item management. Okay, so whether open item management is active or not, this question is for the leading ledger. Okay, so for open item management, if you tick here, it will be only activated for the leading ledger. But for the non-leading ledgers, if you want to specify whether the open item management or clearing is allowed or not, you have to tick this indicator if you want to allow for the non-leading ledgers also. You can see it is specific to the ledger groups. Okay, so that is the only difference between open item management and clearing specific to the ledger group. Next one is sorting key, authorization, group, clerk, abbreviation. I think this all three things will have. Yes.
Please repeat again this point, open item management and clearing specific to ledger group.
Okay, let's go through these wordings, okay, to understand in detail if the wordings are provided. So open item management, you already know what is open item management. So you can
see,
normally for bank clearing, a cash discount clearing, GRIR clearing account, we use this open item management, right? So normally we use this F.13 transaction to automatic clear the GL accounts. So that is open item management. Now, if you see this, which is clearing specific to ledger groups. Okay, so this is mainly for the other ledgers apart from the leading ledger. So determines whether the postings can be made to the account for specific ledger group and whether the account can be cleared. Okay, so let's see if the example is provided. The indicator is only available when you have activated the new GL accounting and you have assigned more than one ledger to the company. Okay, so in short, again, you can see here also, if you want to set this clearing specific to ledger group indicator, you need to have set the only balances in local currency indicator, and it is not permitted for only automatic postings to be made an account with clearing specific to ledger group. So all the properties are same as open item clearing. Only difference is that this open item management is mainly for your leading ledger, and this one is relevant for your other ledgers if you are using more than one ledger in your company code. Okay. Okay. If you have time, we can maybe let's go through this completely to understand end to end. So you can use clearing specific to ledger groups if you perform parallel accounting using the ledger approach. Obviously, if you are using accounts approach, then there is obviously only one ledger. Clearing and making postings specific to ledger group is intended to support you with the closing task. Okay, you can use this function for all items that due to parallel accountings are posted to different multiple ledgers, in particular for provisions and all. Okay, if you set this indicator for the account, this account is then managed as an open item basis, and you can post ledger group specific entries to this account. In this way, you have a ledger group specific view of accounts. Clearing is also performed for specific ledger group. So just read this line once again and you will get the answer. So it is open item basis, and you can post ledger group specific entries to this account. Okay, so in short, just a simple explanation to this is, it is just like the open item management, but normally when you click on this open item management, it is only for the leading ledger, but this will be for other non-leading ledgers. Okay, then let's go to create bank interest. Again, you will not find any change. You have to specify the field status group. So this one is bank. I'll just go with this G005. Keyword translation, no change. Information, no change. Information, no change. Okay, so just click on save. And then I will show you some more scenarios in which there are changes in the GL accounts more than this what we are seeing. Okay, so let me go back once again and let me create one expense GL account. So now I'm creating expense GL account with coding as 400. Click on new. Now this is expense GL account. So can you tell me which one I should use? What should be the account type?
Primary cost.
Primary cost, yes. Because if I want to send the values posted to this GL account to controlling, I will use primary cost. If I want to use this account only in FI, I don't want to send anything from FI to CO, then I will be using non-operating expense or income. So let's go with primary cost or revenue. In the account group, I have to specify the proper account group. In my case, it is profit and loss. And let's say this is refreshment expenses, or maybe insurance, or maybe let's say rent expenses. Okay, so this is nothing but rent expense. If you remember, yes, question. Okay, Prashant, can you just mute yourself if you don't have any question? There was some background noise.
Yeah, one moment.
Okay. Okay, so rent expenses, if you remember in SAP ECC, whenever we were creating any GL account, and if for this GL account we need to send the data to CO, so there was a button here, edit cost element, okay, in which we were providing the cost element category 01 for expenses and 11 for revenues, and for secondary there were multiple different item categories, cost element categories, which were available. Right, but now there is no button for edit cost element. Okay, so what will happen now? Let's see. So if I click on control data, okay, In the control data, you can see that field has come here, cost element category, because there is no separate master data for cost element. The fields are moved from there to here. So the fields related to the cost element are available here. So I have to specify the cost element category here itself. So primary cost. Okay, so all those categories which are available in KA01 or when you were trying to click on edit cost element, all those categories are available here in this screen. Okay, otherwise everything is same. So these were also available in ECC in the controlling when you create the cost element. But just remember one thing, that these fields will become active only when you are selecting this primary cost or revenue or even secondary cost. So which means when you want to create a cost element also. Okay, so for example, when you are creating non-operating expense or income, you'll be only creating a GL. You are not creating the cost element. So these fields will not come. These fields will not be visible at all. But this will be only visible when you are selecting either primary cost or secondary cost. Okay, because for balance sheet and non-operating, we don't need cost element. So that is the reason it will not ask you for cost element categories. Okay, let's go to create bank interest, no change. So for expense account, let's go with the cost accounts and let's try to save this. Okay, so in terms of GL, the very important difference that we have seen is there is a new field called as account type. There is no edit cost element button. In case of primary cost or secondary cost, in the control data, there will be the new field which will be called as cost element category. Okay, so that field has been moved from KA01 to here. Now, was there any more information that we were entering in the edit cost element? When we were clicking on edit cost element, there was one option of account assignments, default account assignments, if you remember. So when you create a cost element, you can provide what would be my default cost center, what would be my default internal order. Do you remember that? Anybody who remembers that? And what are the purpose of that default account?
Yes, yes, and also the field like validation time range, sir. From this date or this year to this year,
validity. Yes. So when we were creating the cost element, system was asking us this cost element is valid from which date to which date, and it was also asking us the default account assignments, which are not mandatory, but you can maintain those. Okay. So first of all, there is no validity anymore. Cost element's validity is gone. There is no valid from. There is no valid to. And second is, even the default account assignments, like if you want to assign that whenever I'll be posting in this GL account 400, by default, this cost center should be picked or this internal order should be picked. That was maintained in edit cost element. So even that option is gone. So now we cannot tell the system that for this GL account 400, we want to default this cost center and in this internal order from create cost element or change cost element screen. Can you tell me which is the other place in SAP where we can maintain the default account assignments? Very common. Based on a particular GL, if I want to default the cost center, which is that field, which is that screen in SAP ECC?
No, BY6.
BY6,
no?
OKB9. OKB9, yes. Yes, OKB9. So OKB9 is a default account assignment screen, which is still available. So in ECC, there were two options. Option number one, you provide this information in the cost element, or you provide this information in OKB9. Now in SAP S/4HANA, there is only one place where you can maintain the default account assignments, and that is OKB9, because the earlier one is completely gone. Okay. Also, when you will be working on the conversion project. Conversion project means what? When customer is already using SAP ECC and he wants to migrate to SAP S/4HANA. So during the migration, all the cost elements will be created as GL accounts, and whatever information, whatever default account assignments are available for the cost elements, they will automatically move to OKB9. Okay, so just remember, in ECC, there were two places where we were defining the account default account assignments. First one was in the cost element master data, and second one was in OKB9. In S4HANA, no more cost element master data related default account assignments. Those are only maintained in OKB9. Okay, so let's go back. OKB9 is still available. And this is also saved. So let me show you one more thing. So for example, if I go for GL account 201, which I'm creating for cash account. So if I click on new, and if I go to type description, account type is balance sheet, account group is balance sheet. Let's say this is my cash account. Now if I go to control data, and if I try to find cost element category, it is not available. Okay, why it is not available? Because cost element category is only applicable for primary cost or secondary cost, not for non-operative expenses, not for balance sheet account. Okay, so let's go to control data once again. So all these things are same, no change. Let's go to create bank interest tab. Again, no change. Everything, most of the things may not be each and everything, but most of the things are same. Most of the important things at least are same. I'm just checking if there is anything else that I need to explain here. So sort and all is okay. Okay, just one more thing. I'm just trying. No problem. So I'll explain you this when we'll be talking about the asset accounting. So as of now, just forget about this. And now just to summarize what we discussed is GL account and cost element has been merged. So you cannot create a cost element using transaction KA01. It has to be created using transaction FS00. If you try KA01, it will automatically redirect you to FS00. When you create a GL account, the first thing system will ask you is account type. There are four different account types, one for balance sheet, one for secondary cost, and two for profit and loss. First one with cost element, second one without cost element. Okay, and based on what you are selecting here, the system will behave. System will ask you cost element category if you are selecting primary cost or revenue or secondary cost. If you are selecting balance sheet or non-operative expenses, in that case, that indicator will not come at all. Okay, and there is no edit cost element button here. Even no default account assignment can be maintained from here. It has to be maintained only using transaction OKB9. Okay, so this was about creation of master data. Okay, now let's do some remaining settings so that we are able to see some transactions. So I'll go to SPRO and we'll see if there is something else which we need to maintain. Definitely there are a lot of things, like we need to talk about the tolerances, we need to talk about the number ranges, but there are no changes there. So I'll be a little bit faster. So let's go to financial accounting. Financial accounting global settings. Let's go to the document, and within the document, there is one new thing. So if I go for document types, functionality as it is, if you double click on the document type, whatever you are able to see, that is also same. Only thing is there is a new field added here called a secondary cost. Okay, and this you know the answer why it is added. It is just added because you want to use this secondary postings also will come to FI via the document types. Okay, and one more thing, special usage for BI only. Okay, which means, let's say if you want to use a particular document type, and as I told you, there is BI functionality is also embedded within the main system. Okay, so let's say you want to use a particular document type, which will be only used for the BI purpose. then you have to tick this indicator. So SAP has already provided the standard document types, which will be using secondary cost and which will be using BI only. Let me show you. Let's go back. Okay, so this one, CO posting, this document type is not available in SAP ECC. You'll be able to see CH is again new. We'll talk about that. DA, DG, DR, DZ, most of the things you will always find KA, KG and all. But this is something which is completely new, document type CO. Now, if you go here, you can see this is only for controlling postings. What do you mean by controlling postings? This means this document type will be used only for CO postings, secondary postings and primary postings, which are related to the CO object. Okay, so for example, if I give you the example here, let's say what documents you post in CO, you perform the distributions, you perform the assessments, you do the settlements. Okay, so in system, all these documents were created in CO earlier and there was nothing affected in FI. But now, if you remember, I told you CO and FI are going to be stored in one table, which means whatever postings you make in CO, they will also go to Universal Journal Table, ACDOC A. And when it will come to ACDOC A, it will definitely have a proper number, it will have a document type. And that is the reason the document type that we will be using for controlling related postings is CO. So this is a new document type which is provided by SAP. We'll talk about this when we'll do the transactions. I'll show you this document type CO. Also, this will also come into the picture. If you already worked on New GL accounting, you will not find anything new here. But if not, we will talk about what is this defined document types in ledger. Let's go to the document number ranges. Okay, so we definitely need to have a document number range. Again, I will copy it from 0001. In our company code, that is SF01. Okay, so number ranges has been copied. Let's go back. What else we need? We definitely need the tolerances, right? Without which system will not allow us to post any document. So define tolerance group for employee. I will again just copy this 0001, no change. This is as it is in ECC. And I'll just change the company code to SF01. Okay, so I'm assuming these are the old things which you already know. Any particular screen, if you are not comfortable or you worked on this screen but you don't know why we do this, please stop me and maybe I'll explain you what exactly are these configurations. Okay, because these are the old configurations, I assume that you already know this. Okay, let's go back. So tolerance is also done. Number ranges are also done. Now let's try to create a simple document and see what errors we are getting and how to solve those errors. So for posting the document, I can again go to normal FB50 transaction. Let's go to FB50 and enter the document date. Let's say today's date. Okay, first of all, we need to change the company code. So clicking on this company code option, going to SF01. Document date 16/01/2019. Reference I'm just putting is as test here. This is also, let's say, test. GL accounts. So we created two GL accounts, one for expense and second for bank. So we will debit the expense account and credit the bank account. So rent expense debit, debit indicator with amount, let's say 1000. And credit would be this GL account, which is bank account. Okay, so credit posting of another 1000. So please enter. Yes, so account 400 requires assignment to the CO object. This is a normal issue that you will also find in SAP ECC, which means system is asking you to create a CO object, to provide the CO object. Okay, so what is a CO object? It can be cost center, it can be internal order, it can be any account assignment object. But we have still not created any controlling object. We have still not created a cost center and profit center and all. So quickly, let's create one cost center, maybe profit center we will add later on, just to go ahead with this document. So same transaction, KS01 to create a cost center. So let's say this is SF01/1, and this is valid from 01/01/2019. Okay, you will not find any change here. So this is my test cost center. Person responsible, let's make it as manager. Cost center category, let's keep it as maybe administration. Hierarchy area, by default SF01, which we created at the time of creation of controlling area. Okay, and currency is INR. Let's click on save. So cost center has been created. Now let's use this cost center here, SF01-1. Okay, now there is another error. Version 0 is not defined for fiscal year 2018. So this is a controlling area setting which we have done. We created a version 0. So let's see what is the problem. SPRO IMG controlling, general controlling, organization maintain the versions, and 0 version for settings for each fiscal year. Yes, it is not maintained, I think. It is starting from 2019. Okay, so let's click on new entry, and or maybe if there is option of copy as. Let's copy this 2018. I'm just making the same settings and click on save. Why it is asking this as a mandatory field? Some mandatory field is there, so let's do one thing. Let's go out completely from here. Cancel. SPRO. Controlling, right? Controlling, general controlling, organization and maintain versions. So for 0, let's go to fiscal year, this one, and let's copy this to 2018. Okay, and save. Perfect. Let's try to enter once again. I think now there is another error. An entry is required in valid date field for account. This is a straightforward error that you will get also in ECC because of field status of this GL account. Okay, so valid date is mandatory field. So 16/01/2018. Let's press enter. Now it seems to be green, and let's try to post it. Okay, so when you are trying to post, system is throwing this error. Correct the customizing settings for ledgers for universal journal, which means configuration is still not complete. There are some steps which might be still missing. Okay, and this is a normal error you will get, which is not telling you what exactly is wrong. It is just telling you there is something wrong. So if you want to know what exactly is wrong, just click on this view details, click on close. It will provide you two programs. Okay, so in order to know what is wrong, it is providing you two programs. You should always click on the second program. I'll tell you why. If you click on this program, it will tell you whatever inconsistencies are there in all the company codes, not only on your company codes. Okay, but if you want to know what is wrong with my company code, which I'm trying to post now, SF01, so I can directly go here. So initially when Simple Finance came, maybe till 16/10, there was only this program available, and it was very difficult for us that if we have 100 companies and system is throwing us all the errors, it is very difficult to find what is wrong with our company code. Okay, and now SAP has provided this program, which is only specific for a particular company code and ledger. So if you click on this, it will tell you what is wrong with your company code. So what it is saying is, correct the customizing settings. See, these settings are okay. So these are all green, but there is something wrong. The wrong is, this is again the normal error, and this is the actual error. Document splitting is active in company code SF01. Activate the profit center accounting and controlling area SF01. So I think in this system, somebody has activated the document splitting for a profit center label, and that is the reason profit center is must. Okay, so this is again not a new error. Even in SAP ECC, if you activate the document splitting and if you don't provide the profit center, you will get this error. Okay, so anyways, we need to activate the profit center. So let's go back. Let's go to transaction KE51. But before we maintain the profit center, we need to activate the profit center accounting. Okay, so how we activate profit center accounting? Same steps as in ECC. So it will be under controlling, profit center accounting, general controlling, organization, maintain controlling area. Sorry, am I correct? No, just give me a minute. Profit center accounting, basic settings, controlling area settings, and maintain controlling area settings. Okay, so profit center accounting, basic settings, controlling area settings, and maintain controlling area settings. So for SF01, it is still not active. You can see activate indicator is unticked. So we have to create a standard hierarchy. Again, let's create it as the same SF01. You have to specify the currency type, which is normally the controlling area currency. Okay, same, even in ECC, you will find the same thing. There is nothing new here. Just activate this indicator and click on save. So profit center accounting is now active. We should not get this error anymore. So let's close this. If you're not able to close, yeah, anyways, it's closed. So let's go back. Again, now you will be able to close because you've gone from this transaction. Okay, and now let's try to simulate and let's try to post. So finally, the document has been posted in company code SF01. So now if I want to see this document, what we do normally, we go for more, document, and display. Okay, FB03. So it is showing you this document. So document is posted with document number, this one. Document date, reference, currency, nothing new. Okay. It is showing you which GL account was debit and which GL account was credit. If you want to change the layout, again, same in SAP ECC. If you want to know multiple currencies, you can see amount in currency 2, amount in currency 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. If you have defined multiple currencies, up to 8 currencies, we'll be able to see the details here. Okay, so let's say as of now, I just want to go with, okay, anyways, we have not activated multiple currencies. So there was only one currency. So you will see in the table directly. Okay, so that was about currency. You can change the layout as you were doing in SAP ECC. Now let's try to see what are the tables which are affected. Okay, so if I go for SE16N, BKPF, which are the tables that we were using in SAP ECC? Which tables are getting updated when you create any accounting document?
BKPF, BSAL.
BKPF and BSAL, right? BKPF was a table which was header table. Okay, so for company code SF01, if I execute this, So here it is called as online. So just click on online. It is still showing the data. So what was your understanding? Can you tell me whether this is correct or not? What have you heard till now? BKPF is available in S/4HANA or it is gone?
Available.
Is it available in SAP S/4HANA also? Then what is AC docking? Why we need AC docking? BKPF is available, you are correct. Okay, let's see. What about BSEC? BSEC is also available or that is gone?
Available.
BSEC is also available. So if BKPF is also available, BSEC is also available, then what is the point in going for AC Doc A? Why AC Doc A? BSEC is also available. So what is the point of having AC Doc K table?
AC Doc will be for all fresh implementation as well as even the existing projects also.
Yeah, so definitely for fresh implementations as well as current system.
Yeah.
No, you mean to say in ECC you have AC Doc A?
No, it's only in S4.
It's only in S4, but then what is the difference? So even BKPF and BSEC also are available in both, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So let me tell you this one. So as of now, again, why I don't know. BKPF is still available. And the target of AC Doc A is not to replace the main tables of SAP. It is not to replace the table BKPF and BSEC. It was trying to replace the new GL tables like Fagel Flexa. So earlier Fagel Flexa table was used, but now if you go for table Fagel Flexa, sorry, I just came out. So SE16N Fagel Flexa. Okay. So again, if I go for company code SF01 and go online, I'll be still able to see the data. Okay, so data is still available in SF01 also. Okay, but I'll tell you what is the difference between this Fagel Flexa and AC Doc A. So Fagel Flexa, although it is appearing that it is available, the data is available, but actually speaking, there is no table called as Fagel Flexa in SAP. It is in SAP S/4HANA. It has been converted, as you can see here, it has been converted as a view. It is a compatibility view. I'll tell you what is a compatibility view and all, but this is no more the table, this is just a view. Okay, so in short, BKPF is available, BSEC is available, Fagel Flexa is not available, and new table which is incorporated is AC Doc. So what is the difference between BSEC? See, BSEC is also giving us line level information. If I go for company code, yes, Akash. Okay, so if I go for table BSEC, I'm able to see two lines, but if I go for table AC Doc A, okay, again, same company code SF01, for the same document, I'm able to see how many lines? Four lines. Okay. What is the difference between AC Doc A and BSEC?
Leading letters.
I think difference is we can't in here S4 we can see OA, GRL as well as IF. IFRS reporting also we can see here. But in ECC we can't see that this type of data.
No, the question is not ECC versus S/4HANA. So even in ECC also, if you activated new GL accounting, you can get IFRS reporting from Fagel Flexa. Okay, but BSEC, even if you are using SAP ECC and you are using new GL accounting, BSEC only stores leading ledger data. Irrespective of whether you are working on ECC or S/4HANA, your BSEC table will only hold leading ledger data. It will not hold any other data apart from leading ledger. Okay. In case of ACDoc A, it is holding not only leading ledger, it is holding the data of each and every ledger. Okay, you can see it is holding the data for IFRS also. If you activate more number of ledgers, it will show you that much number of line items. Okay, and another benefit of using ACDoc A is it is not only storing the data of headers, it is also storing the data of line in the same. So header data as well as line level data is available in table ACDoc A. So ACDoc A is a combination of BKPF and Faggle Flexa. Faggle Flexa has been replaced, but whatever content was available in SAP ECC in Faggle Flexa, that will be now available in table ACDoc A. Okay, let me show you one more thing now. So if I go for this document which we created, okay, in this document, if I go for document overview, what is document overview? Document overview will tell you how many documents were created when you created this document. So there may be the FI document, there may be the CO document, there may be a lot of documents which are created, right? So if you go to document environment and you go to accounting documents, you can see two documents were created, accounting document and CO document. Now in SAP ECC, whenever you create any accounting document, and if it is also creating controlling document, so the document number must be the proper number, like this one. This is a proper number, right? 1, 9 times or 8 times 0. But this is a dummy number. Controlling number, if you see, this is a statistical number. Dummy number. Why it is a dummy number? The reason is this one document number is enough for accounting and controlling. Now you don't need separate document for accounting and separate document for controlling. In ECC, accounting document was different, controlling document was different. But now since both of them are merged, accounting document and controlling document is same document, this one. This is just for the statistical purpose. Okay, so even the controlling data, earlier for controlling data, we were going to tables like COSK, COSP, COSS. Now controlling data will be also available in ACDoc A. Okay, so if you, for example, in BKPF and BSEG, it was not possible to find out this posting was happened to which cost center. But now if you go to ACDoc A table, you will be able to see even the cost center information, profit center information, controlling area, everything is available. Okay, so not only FI data, ACDoc A is also holding the CO data in the same table. So we don't need any separate tables for controlling. Okay, this is another benefit of ACDoc A, one single table which is holding the data of FI and CO both. Okay, but please remember that in ACDoc A table, the difference between BSEG and ACDoc A is in BSEG, it will only show you leading ledger data, but in ACDoc A, it will show you leading ledger as well as non-leading ledger data available here. Okay. Any questions? Let me show you one more thing. If I go to my ledger settings now, if you go to financial accounting global settings, ledgers, ledger and define settings for ledgers and currency type. So earlier, if you remember, for company code SF01, you can see this currency was blank earlier. Okay, I told you this currency is nothing but controlling area currency. So when we create a controlling area, this currency will come automatically. So when we created a controlling area, system has automatically determined this global currency and CO object currency. Okay, these are default. 10 and 70 is, if you are using company code, controlling area same as company code, this will be 10. Otherwise, it will be cross company code controlling. Okay, so controlling area currency will come here. this cost object currency will always remain same, 70, controlling object currency. Okay, any questions till now? Maybe last one, let me show you some tables for the master data. So just to avoid any kind of confusion, all the master data tables are as it is. So for example, you have for GL master, you have SKA1 table, right? For chart of account level. So if you specify the chart of account SF01, it will show you two GLs that we created. Okay, it will tell you whether it is a balance sheet account or a profit and loss. It will tell you even the GL account type. So these are the four options. So you'll be still getting the data in SKA1 for chart of account level. For company code level, still you will be using SKB1. So for company code SF01, if you go for online, again, you can see this information is available here. What were the tables for controlling cost elements? We created one cost element, right? Which were the tables for the cost elements? Anyone who remembers the table? It was CSKA, right? For chart of accounts. So chart of account is SF01 online. You can see even the cost element table is same. So CSKA, CSKB are still available. This is for the controlling area level. So SF01, and it will show you the data. Okay, this is by default. See, system is not asking us valid from valid date. This is something which is automatically getting stored in the background. By default, system is putting it from 1900 to 9999.
Gaurav, I hope BSIS table is gone, right?
Which one?
BSIS and BSAS table is gone.
The master tables. So BSIS, BSAS, if you try these tables, okay, and let's say if I go for company code SF01, you'll be still able to see the data. Data is still available, but these tables are actually no more available. They are converted as views. So what are we going to do tomorrow is I will show you how to check whether a particular table is still a table or it has been converted as a view. Okay, so BSAS, Faggle FlexD, I'll show you some examples of the tables which are no more available as the tables, but they are converted as a view.
Gaurav, these view tables don't have, don't store any data, right?
They don't store any data physically in the database, but from the reporting point of view, they are still available.